Alright, here's an update on my 29-gallon freshwater tank. I just took my Opisthogramma cacatoidae. It's kind of like an electric yellow, double red. And one of my corridor catfish, and put him back in here. I had him upstairs in my room, and then had a little bit of trouble, and they lost their pigmentation, so I brought him back down here. He really likes this cave I made out of the bottom of a seltzer bottle. Just cut it off, cut one of the little protruding peg things, and then you've got yourself a nice little cave. It'll work especially well if you have sand, because you can easily move it around. He is like addicted to that thing. He barely comes out anymore. He seems to like it a lot, so I'm kind of happy. Oh, I also moved a betta upstairs. Or downstairs, I mean. And I took the sponge filter from their tank upstairs, put it in here, because I lowered the water level and the regular power hang-on filter isn't really working that well. So I just added a little bit more because the tank's really clearing up, like almost perfect clarity, because it used to be really cloudy and I couldn't figure out why. So I just added a little bit more biological filtration to try and clear it up a little bit more. So that's it. I've still got my DIY, do-it-yourself, self-loving siphon running. It goes like right there, somewhere behind there. See if I can get a bill. Well, anyway, goes down the tube and drips into this bucket. It's got a pretty fast drip right now. Over the past like 3 days, it's filled up to here, if you can see it or not. Amazon Sword's doing pretty well. Here's my other 10 gallon that I've been keeping up. My female guppy's pregnant. I think she's about to give birth maybe a week or so. I was asking if I should put her in a breeding trap. We've got an aqua nursery thing. It separates the fry from the mom with air power and different chamber. It's pretty cool. It's in my garage right now. I don't even know why. This Amazon sword used to be in the 29 gallon, but it was doing pretty crappily. So I put it in here where all my plants thrive for some mysterious reason. I think it's because of the light penetration in this tank, because it used to be cloudy in the 29, like I already said. So I cut off all the dead leaves. Some new leaves are coming up, if you can see them. Pretty small, but should get bigger soon. And here's the baby of that plant. It is far outgrown its parent. Kind of ridiculous. And I've got some hair grass trying to get it started back up again, because it wasn't doing so well in my 29 gallon. And my other cockatoidy. I think he's a little bit of spine problem on his tail, but his coloration is much better than the one in the 29 gallon.